Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to discuss the topic flowchart for control system. This is for the week 15 for automation 1. So in here we have the STCW function taken from the table of competence. So you just play this one so that we can proceed. So flowcharts for automatic and control system. Learning objectives: create flowcharts for the automation and control system. So in this discussion, I use a simulator. I use the maneuvering system of the main engine as well as the fuel oil purifier system. Also, I use also the diagram of sequential flow control. So, I explain marks used in the flowchart such as terminal, processing determination, output. Input output stira. So explain flowcharts indicating automatic control for main engine, generator control, and others, taking some of the examples. So your oral recitation I will schedule later, and I give also quiz 9. So for the laboratory exercise number 14, flowchart for control system. So you have to download from your binocle. So your topic, this is here, create a flowchart for automation and control system. Flowchart for automatic and control system. So it says here, explain symbol marks used in flowcharts such as terminal, processing, determination, output, etc. So explain flowcharts indicating automatic control system for main engine, generator, control system, and others, taking some of the examples. So I will be using the system of the main engine, which is main engine maneuvering system. So I use this system. So in here, these are pipelines. As you can see, all the lines here are pipelines. So yeah, pipeline. So the one that is colored is filled with air, and the others are not colored, which is black here. The is there is no flow yet, there is not yet flow of air. So in here, as you can see, a lot of solenoid valves. These are solenoid valves. This piston cylinder, solenoid valves, as you can see, are pneumatic valve. So pneumatic valve. Here, there are pneumatic solenoid valve, and this one is a pneumatic cylinder. Solenoid valve. So this is tank. So this is a pneumatic safety air tank. So you have here the reversing mechanism. This is your camshaft, your exhaust valve, your fuel pump, engine control room, and your main engine local control. Start here, distributor black valve, this one, city air black valve, start air black valve on your tuning gear. So to simulate the function of this system with this diagram, the main engine maneuvering system, I had to, normally this one is in remote, so maneuvering in the control room. Local is only for emergency at the engine side. So so that I can see this page, I will put this one in local. So let's say we will start the engine into local control. So as you can see here, your maneuvering system is not yet working. Although there is a solenoid or the pneumatic valve is open here, as you can see the line is filled with air. Here, as you can see, but still a lot of pipeline is not open, and also the solenoid valve at the start the engine is not open. So I will put first in the ahead. So we will start the engine ahead. So here we will start the engine still. So I'll start the engine ahead. So this one. So we will see what will happen as the flow of the air so that the engine will start. So this is a flow chart of or flow diagram of the automation and control system. So I will start the engine now ahead. So I will start the engine. So there is an alarm because of the what we call the air pressure. Low air pressure. So I press again so that you can see what is happening. So as you can see, when I start the engine, your pneumatic valve here or the solenoid valve is open, you see. So this open, this is this system is one example of a sequential control, because when I put I start here the engine, this solenoid valve is opening. As you can see here, now it's opening. So it sends a air pressure to another solenoid valve, this one, or pneumatic valve, and send air pressure. So you see here, see, so air pressure here your starting air distributor, and also here since pre send pressure, so you can see this one. In this pneumatic valve or the solenoid valve, pneumatic solenoid valve, and sends or also pressure to your pneumatic valve for your fuel pump or injection pump. And here also sends send pressure, air pressure, to your reversing cylinder, so to ahead, so say, because we start our engine to ahead. So here also since pre send air pressure to your main starting valve to open the pressure of 30 bar, which is your starting air. Push the piston here. So here the first fire now is cylinder number 5. This is different. Cylinder number 5. So that is how it is happening when I start the engine ahead. So I will also start the engine astern. So the same procedure, but we have to reverse the engine so that the ship will run astern. So now I will transfer to astern. So I will now transfer to astern. So as you can see, this your reversing cylinder or reversing mechanism, this change to astern. So as you can see, so this is there's an alarm. This alarm is different. It's not included in this discussion, but anyway, since we are using the machinery, so we are operating the machinery, so I will rectify. So I will transfer the suction here. So this is not included to your discussion. This is different, but just to rectify the alarm. So maneuvering system. So as you can see here, this is I will put in ahead. So your limit, limit switch here is transferring to ahead. And your, so as you can see, so we'll ahead, then we'll transfer to astern. So later on, this one will transfer to astern. Reversing cylinder or reversing mechanism. So now I will start the engine to astern. So what will happen now? So I will start and I press so that you can see what is happening. So as you can see, this one is in center, so I move this piston there. Now, so as you can see, I press again so that you can see what is happening. So as you can see, the piston of reversing mechanism is transferring to astern, as well as your cam transferring to astern. So it was ahead before here. So it is also the same, the pneumatic valve or pneumatic solenoid valve is operating. So now here, as you can see, your pneumatic valve here is transferred to astern. So your what we call your reversing mechanism, this one already to astern. Before it was ahead. So your engine is running or starting. You see? So these are all, so as you can see, a lot already of line which is filled control air. It is already colored. You see? But before it was black like this. Only few has an control air inside of the pipe. So because of your pneumatic valve are closed, some of pneumatic valve are closed. So this is one example of the sequential control, which is the applied the control system. This is a maneuvering system, control system. So I will start the engine again to ahead. There is an alarm. So I will start again the engine to ahead. So as you can see, your limit switch is transferring to ahead. And later on, this your reversing cylinder piston will transfer to ahead, as well as your pneumatic valve here, the solenoid pneumatic valve will give air pressure to ahead, so to transfer this piston. I will start now. Go ahead. Then I will press so that you can see. So as of now, so as you can see, your reversing mechanism is on the ahead position now, and your cam is on the ahead position. So as you can see, the solenoid for the ahead pneumatic solenoid pneumatic valve is giving pressure to ahead to push this piston. So if you notice here, a lot of how many now? Pneumatic valve 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is operated, as well as your this one, your slow turning valve, and your main starting valve is operated. Also your so this is the solenoid valve, pneumatic valve for the reversing mechanism. So only one control here deliver you start, but there are components 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 are operated, so as well as your piston. So without so this is example of sequential control, because when this lever here, the start lever of the engine, is put into start, the solenoid, the start solenoid here is open and giving pressure to a different solenoid that are required to start the engine. So that is one example of the sequential control, so or the automation system. Now let us come here with the HFO separator. So HFO separator 1. So I'm going to start now, and we will see when I start the ALCAP control. This purifier works in automatic control system as well as the system of the sequential system because of this this one, the waiting for speed, waiting for temperature, although here temperature is not far, but because I just stopped this one for the demonstration purposes. So, and the discharging sequence and the draining sequence. So here also is the alarm indication. So I will start now this purifier, and we will see the working process of the sequential control. So first here the there is what we call the closing water for your bowl, and here is the opening water, and here is your sealing water. So, so that the oil will not leak. So I will start now. So here I remove the brake, and then so I start the feed pump, and then I open the steam to heater. So as you can see now, this will supposedly increase the temperature because we set the temperature controller to auto. Here also I will start the purifier. I try to start the ALCAP. Start this one. So it's not the so I'll start the motor now. So now when first time starting the purifier motor, it's a lot of current amperes. So because it is still low speed, very heavy to turn. So as you can see here, this is a indication is here is waiting for speed. So and your your opening water is close, of course, and your sitting water, so because still waiting for speed. So that is one example of the sequential control. So when the electric the motor is up to speed, already high speed, normal speed, the current or the amperes will decrease to normal, and this waiting for speed will disappear. So we can start the ALCAP. So as you can see here, there is no flow to the purifier. So the circulation of the fuel by the feed pump is only circulating here. Line, so out discharge the feed pump back to feed pump, then just circulate. So this is an example of sequential control, because when everything is not ready, when one part is not ready, one component, then the other component will not work. So we'll wait. So as you can see now, the amperes is going down to around 12 amperes. So as you can see, the ceiling water is opening. So the solenoid valve for the ceiling water. And then the discharging sequence is operating, as you can see. So your temperature is normal, no more indication, waiting for temperature. So everything is moving when you start the purifier system, but it is not moving at the same time. So different part in different time because of the sequence. So now everything is ready, so we can, as you can see, is there as the circulation of fuel here. So when we start the ALCAP, there is a fuel will flow the purifier to purifier, and it will be discharged. Then the sludge is accumulated here. Then after let's say we set the disludging, the automatic disludging, here is a manual, but in the system there is automatic disludging. After, for example, after 1 hour, we set into the disludging is 1 hour, so it will automatically controlled by your ALCAP system. After 1 hour, we'll discharge the sludge. So I will start now the ALCAP. So what will happen now? So we will see. So your ceiling water is opening. So that is an example of sequence control. So still there is no flow here, but we will see. So now the flow is start entering to the purifier, the flow of fuel. So we'll see, we'll wait. So this is normal when you start a fuel oil purifier. So this is controlled by ALCAP control system. So now, as you can see, there is already a flow to your discharge. As you can see, but before it was zero. As you can see. So every time your solenoid valve to the closing water giving water here to maintain the closing of the bowl. Every time it's operated. So as you can see, the what we call the purifier is working according to H sequence by the use of the ALCAP control system. So this is one example of the sequence system. As you can see, you have already discharged. So I will transfer to another example, another simulation. So I have to stop this demonstration here for a moment because I will also create another simulation which is a sequential control also. This is how automation works on the ship. With regards to the control system, with regards to the automation. So another example, which is the sequencer used for liquid mixing. So we have here the block diagram. So first, in this diagram, we have the tank A, tank B, tank C. And we have also the mixer. And we have the valve A, valve B, valve C, valve D. And we have also the liquid level A sensor, and we have the liquid level B sensor. We have the valve F also, and the valve D, and we have the mixture out. So now we will simulate how this sequencer control system using this block diagram working. So first, we have here the liquid sensor A. If the tank A is empty, so let's say we run this sequencer control system. So when the tank A is empty, the liquid level sensor A sends signal to your sequencer. That's why this is called sequencer control system. And then your sequencer sends signal to the liquid valve A. There. So it opens the valve A to fill up the tank A. So when the tank A is full and it reaches to the liquid level A sensor, it detects, it sends again signal to the sequencer. So your sequencer sends signals also to your liquid valve A to close the valve. So now, the cycle is done. So your remember that tank A and the content of the tank A and tank B is going to be mixed. So we will mix tank content of the tank A and tank B. So in the same way, tank B liquid level B sensor. So if tank B is empty or low level, your tank liquid level B sensor send signal to your sequencer also. So your sequencer also send signal to liquid valve B to open the valve. So it filling up the water to valve B. So when your tank B is full, until the liquid level sensor B, which is detected the level, it sends again signal to your sequencer. So your sequencer sends signal to your liquid valve B to close the valve. So it's stopping the filling up of tank A and tank B. So after that, your tank A and tank B is full, then your valve C and your valve D, your sequencer send signal to valve C and valve D to open the valve C and valve D. Therefore, your tank A and your tank B is filling up water to tank C. So your tank C, when the mixing is completed, so your tank C will send signal to the sequencer. Then your sequencer will send signal to valve A. So that is the working process of the sequencer control system. So as our example, our black diagram is a sequencer used for liquid mixing. So there is a mixing out here after it is completed the process. And it repeats again the whole process when you continue using the system. So that is an example of the sequencer control system. So you have to I hope you learn this demonstration, and next this after you watch this demonstration, so you have to do your lab manual exercise. So just read carefully your lab manual exercise. So in here, in the most basic sense, flowcharts or flow is the type of diagram that describe processes. So this diagram is composed of blocks, often rectangular, that are connected by arrows. So the blocks, block diagram. Blocks contain information of a single step in a process in such a way the blocks help keep the content of the process concise. So flow lines in turn serve signify the direction or flow of the steps in a given process. So flow chart is a very simple yet powerful tool to improve productivity in both our personal and work life. So here we are some ways a flowchart can be helpful. So document a process, present a solution, brainstorm an idea. So design a system, explain a decision-making process, store information. Flowchart is a very intuitive method to describe process, such as in most cases, you don't need to worry too much about the standards and rules, all the flowchart symbols. So in fact, a flowchart constructed with just rectangular blocks and flow lines can already get most jobs done. So here is your sequencer used for liquid mixing. So as an example of the flow charts of the automation system. So later on I will discuss this one. I will continue. I will first discuss the what we call the main engine maneuvering system and the low oil purifier system. So after those two scenarios, so I will discuss this one. I will proceed. So in your lab manual exercises, so you have to read this one carefully, this instruction. So by the use of the block diagram of the sequencer control. So you have to read this one. So this is the form of your what we call the your lab manual exercise. So I already uploaded this one in your LMS, which is Binnacle. So you have to download this form, have it printed, and you have to do your exercise in handwritten, because supposedly you have to use your lab manual. Since we are using now the electronic or the paperless submission, so you are allowed to print. And after the completion of your exercise, you have to take a clear picture, save it in Word document, and convert it in PDF format and upload to Binnacle. So in your exercise, you have to read carefully the instruction with regards with this what we call this diagram. So I already discussed this one including with the main engine maneuvering system, fuel oil purifier system, and also this one, which is the sequencer used for liquid mixing, or the sequencer diagram. So, this is the instruction of your lab manual exercise. Uh, And this is the form. So this is the at the end of your discussion. So thank you for watching this discussion. Please click like and share. Write a notification. Write a comment below. Please don't forget that. Sorry, I made mistake. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon. Thank you for watching and see you on my next video discussion.